Good morning, everyone. So this morning's topic is the bounds of healing. This is a, like all of the topics, really one that we can continue to unpack over and over and over again, getting deeper and deeper. Because when it comes to our own transformation, we find that the process, I believe, is a slow one. We might have dramatic healings, but even in those dramatic healings, oftentimes the play out and the integration take time. It's step by step by step. And so I bring up this topic again because it never hurts to, in this moment, become very intimate with where we are in our freedom around being filled with spirit and acting on spirit. We'll find in our lives that even as we change, everything around us changes. And sometimes it changes in conversation with ourselves and we're compatible with it. And sometimes we find that what used to fit and work no longer fits and works. So coming to a boundless place in healing is coming to a place where we are so free that we don't hold on to the things that don't work anymore. We bless them and say goodbye, recognize that for a time and a place, they did serve us, they did work. But as we grow, inevitably, many of the things that worked for us don't work anymore. And we bind ourselves when we attach our idea of freedom to what it should play out in our relationships and in our structures. We limit the transformation within ourselves when we rationalize and parlay it against the very structures and relationships. I have an example from this great story of Jesus healing somebody on the Sabbath. And I tell the story because it's a true testimony to how free this person, Jesus, was. And I believe it's meant to be an inspiration for us to live in that degree of freedom. Jesus isn't putting himself above the law. It would be conjecture to say he's trying to make a statement against the law. All we have is that he freely acted. So let me share the story with you. Jesus had gone up to Jerusalem for one of the Jewish festivals, and he was near the sheep gate at a pool, which some call Bethesda. It's surrounded by five covered colonnades. Many disabled people used to lie there, the blind, the lame, the paralyzed. And there was one man who was an invalid for 38 years. When Jesus saw him lying there and learned that he had been in this condition, he said to him, "Do you want to get well?" "Sir," the invalid replied, "I have no one to help me into the pool when the water is stirred. While I'm trying to get in, someone else goes in ahead of me." Now, a little side note, it was believed that from time to time, when the waters would be stirred, it was an angel of the Lord, and the first one in would be healed. So that's why many laid there to try to be the first one in the pool. Jesus just said to him, "Get up, pick up your mat, and walk." And at once the man was cured. He picked up his mat and walked. Now, this was on the Sabbath, and so Jewish leaders came across this man walking, holding his mat. You can imagine how happy he was in that moment, holding this mat, walking around. And he's like, "The law forbids you to carry your mat." And he said, "But the man who cured me said, 'Pick up your mat and walk.'" And of course, the leaders wanted to know who this man was, because to cure on the Sabbath was illegal as well. Now, finally, they did get to talk to Jesus and confront him about this. And his only reference was, "My Father in heaven is at work even now, so I am at work as well." And if you were a leader who was bound to the laws, that would appear that this healer was putting themselves above the law. But we have no reason to believe that Jesus was purposefully doing anything like that. What we do know is that the phrase gives an insight that the Spirit is always moving and always at work within us. And our faithfulness, our boundlessness, our freedom lies in the becoming more and more attuned to being in that Spirit, so that we too, as ambassadors of the light, as healers, that we aren't positioning ourselves within, against, above, below, in relationship on any way, shape, or form to the structures that help society work, but rather we are attentive to the movement of Spirit and acting in its life-giving force for ourselves and others. That's all we have Jesus giving reference to. He doesn't make any other response other than giving a witness that the Spirit moved. And if it moved, he was going to move with it. If it wasn't of God, how could the healing have taken place? So that is our meditation today, that we ourselves may be granted the gift, the fortification, the insight to live that place of simple freedom. Our lives are so very short, and we have but just this breath to breathe the life of God and to be breathed in that life of God. So this morning's meditation is hopefully an infusion of that freedom in which we're called to live. So I invite you to close your eyes. And bring your attention to your breath. And staying close to the breath, very close, notice how the breath arises within you this morning. Just notice it, how it spontaneously expands the body and air is received. Notice that you, as a fully autonomous being, are breathing. Notice that as you, a breathing, autonomous being, are in relationship with this breath, that there is really only one other relationship, and that is the mystery. Of the breathing itself. Perhaps it is one relationship between you and Source. Between you and the uncreated. Between you and divine consciousness. Relax into the freedom of this transparency and authenticity. And let this freedom and this moment of transparency, let it move through the physical body, whether it is allowing the breath or being breathed to move all the way to the tips of your fingers and top of your head and tips of your toes. Or whether it's a magnification where the breath seems to infuse you with greater light. Let this moment be about you and the being breathed itself. And we begin to end this rich, short devotional. But I invite you as much as you can to walk in this autonomy today. In pulling into your autonomy and being breathed with each step like Jesus was, you actually move into a boundless state because you retract from the limiting ways you may be in relationship with all around you. Let yourself, though, as you pull in, not recluse or disassociate, but only gain greater resource so that you have boundlessness in relation to what may arise within your day. And let yourself notice one more large inhale. And one more large exhale. When you're ready, open your eyes. Have a fantastic day, everybody.